So our first speaker is Professor Niloy Ganguly from IIT Kharagpur. He has been, I can very clearly say that he's the pioneer of social network research in the modern era in India. So he's one of the most well-known social research social network researcher in the world, actually. And I have the privilege of working and, you know, starting the group, which is now called CNRG in IIT Kharagpur. What is the full
Complex
form?
Networks Research Group.
Complex Networks Research Group. It's a very big group now, and they do all kinds of fascinating studies. And as you can see, Niloy is going to talk about, you know, mining disaster events from Twitter. So over to you, Niloy.
Okay. Thank you, Monojit, for the embarrassment. And thanks, Monojit and Kolika, for the invitation. Yeah. So this is a work which is mostly a work in progress. Okay. So it's a work on understanding various facets of disaster events, how microblocks interacts during disaster events. So this is my student Kostap, who is actually driving the project, and all of us are actually free riding on him. So this is Saptarshi, myself Niloy, Pavan is one of my colleague, and we have a group from QCRI, Qatar Institute of Research, Imran and Prashanjit, and Siddhartho is Prashanjit's student, who is also participating in the project. So we have one publication, but several others are under submission. So somehow this is going. Okay, anyway, it's not coming, the bottom line. Anyway, it's fine. So let us go straight. I think it doesn't matter. Okay. So let us go straight into the topic. So what we see that actually last 5 years we have seen that in developed country Twitter has been widely used during disaster. But in recent like 2-3 years, we are seeing also Twitter being widely used in Indian context. So you see in Hyderabad blast, there was a lot of tweets which were going around and which were important tweets. So this is the broad objective of the entire work. It's to improve utilization of OSNs in the aftermath of natural and man-made disaster through retrieval of useful. I have just put a underline on useful. We'll try to understand what is useful. Okay, useful information. So talking about useful, there are actually situational tweets like which inform the current situation in the disaster. It contain help information like phone numbers of nearest hospital, etc. So you can see Hyderabad blast help number, etc., etc. Avoid making calls unless necessary. Or 15,000 tourists stranded due to landslide in Uttarakhand. Okay, these are like situational tweets which go on during disaster. And also you will see various non-situational tweets going on, like sympathy, request for charity, suggestion, donation, post-analysis of events. So see, extremely sad day, my prayers to the victims and their families affected by the Hyderabad blast. Or why do VVIPs have to go to the site within an hour of the blast, lest police do policing? So these are opinion sort of tweets which are going around. And also we see that there are mixtures. It's not that situation, there are distinct situational tweets and non-situational tweets. So there are mixtures of situational and non-situational fragments, like away, not again, blast in Hyderabad, 7 killed TV report. So 7 killed is something which is situational, but you also have opinions which are going on. Oh no, unconfirmed reports that the incident in New Town City may be a school shooting, police on the way. So the information of school shooting is coming, but also you are getting some sort of opinions information. Okay, may God save the rest, 58 deaths and 58,000 trapped. Okay. So with this understanding of the tweets, this is the scheme of the, this is the plan, this is the research agenda. So one thing is, when we are trying to understand we may try to understand situational tweets, or we may try to understand non-situational tweets, and we may try to have some sort of summary, okay? So some sort of summary on the situational tweets and some sort of summary of the non-situational tweets. The importance of summary is during this event, there will be thousands, even tens of thousands of tweets continuously going on. So if I think of a control center who wants to leverage from the tweets, actually taking this, using this tens of thousands of tweets may be difficult. So what is needed is some sort of middleware where you give some sort of summary, but that summary should be online, or that summary needs to be fast, because you cannot take your entire time to actually generate summaries. Okay. So with this, let us just see the scheme. So the first is the fragmentation. Fragmentation means what we were talking, that tweets may be combinations of situational and non-situational. So can we remove that? That is number one. Number two is, can we classify tweets from situational to non-situational and then generate the summaries? So in disaster events, when we see a situation, there are a lot of numbers. I score some health numbers, number of people dead, various addresses. So this sort of numbers comes in situational tweets. So as soon as you have seen numbers, you may think that those are actually situational tweets. And whereas when you see WH words, they are opinion tweets. And if you see personal pronouns, they are opinion tweets. So you can actually take out a lot of features. Just by seeing, you can take out a lot of features and can see that there are intensifiers, emoticons, question marks, subjective words, which actually confirm whether it is a situational tweet or not situational. So taking this into consideration and taking these five sort of data sets where you have school shooting in Sandy Hook Elementary School, typhoon has put in Philippines, two bomb blasts in Hyderabad, devastating flood and landslide in Uttarakhand, earthquake in Nepal. And we collected tweets on all these five events, considering 500. I will talk about other language tweets later, but the initial work is on English language. Okay, in chronological order, and with standard techniques of annotating interactive agreement, we get accuracy of like 78%. So it's around 80%. But what is interesting, if you see the ICWSM paper, their accuracy. Okay, so I should explain this a bit more. That if you see each row, okay, so this is like you are testing on Uttarakhand flood, but you have trained on Hyderabad first. So you are testing on Uttarakhand flood, but you are trained on Hyderabad flood. So what do you see? That the ICWSM paper immediately goes down when it is a different event, while our classifier stands, it decreases a bit, but it stands even when we have different events. So this is how we actually have a cross-domain scenario. We actually tackle the cross-domain scenario and make the classifier more event independent. Okay. So this is about classification. I will come back to it. But then when we have the classification, after we have the classification, we have the situational tweets with us. But still the situation, so just to tell you, the situational tweets and non-situational tweets are like 50-50, okay? So even then you have a lot of situational tweets which are coming out, and those situational tweets actually cannot be used. Okay, means for a control station person really to use all those tweets is difficult. So we need some sort of summarization. So the first sort of summarization which we begin to think is about extractive summarization. So just to bring everybody on board. So when we are talking about extractive summarization, it is we will try to have representative tweets which will represent the entire tweet sets. Okay. So that is what we try to do. Okay. So when we talk about extractive summarization, again we go back and try to see the quiz, and we again see some sort of specific features like new models. There are new models. So just to tell you that this is nothing we are talking about, say World Cup event. Okay. So when we talk about World Cup event, there are a lot of variety in tweets. Okay. Because we can talk about our emotion, we can talk about various sorts of situations. What happened in 1966 World Cup? Okay. So if you see World Cup events, there is a lot of history situational tweets which was happening in 1966 minute how Lineker solved something. Okay. So those sort of events. Lineker was not there in 1966, but yes. So those sort of situational tweets you begin to see. So see this interesting observation. So when we take five events, Uttarakhand flood, Nepal earthquake, typhoon Agabur, Hagapur, smartphone, and Obama. Okay, these are the five events which we take and try to find out the number of content words which are found in those tweets. So number of content words means number of effective words, not like stop words. Those are effective words which are found in those tweets. So as you see that in disaster events, so higher the peak, higher the number of content words. As you see, at x-axis is number of tweets is increasing. As you see in disaster event, the number of content words actually doesn't increase much. Because we don't have much to tell, means that our vocabulary is actually limited. So if you look, step back and think a bit, our vocabulary is actually very limited. Okay. And then when we see those tweets, many of these tweets are actually media repetition. Okay. Many of these tweets, some are retweets,
But many of these twins are actually near recognition. So keeping this in mind, so the objective when we are doing the summarization is simple, that maximize the coverage of these content words, because content words are small in number and they are actually repeated. So if I do a summary where the content words presence is maximized, that may be a very good summary. So this is a simple inclusion on which we go. So then we have a ILP-based solution. We have an integrated linear programming thing where there are several constants like length, etc. But essentially, we try to maximize the score of content words. Okay. So once we do this, again, in order to publish paper, we have to compare with various techniques. Some are online techniques and some are not so online techniques, but we have to compare with Samler, which is a SIGAIA 2013, then this NAPS RTS. So all sorts of techniques we have to compare. And again, this slide would have come, otherwise the paper would not get accepted. Ours was better than all the others. So, but one important thing I just want to talk about Samler, that Samler, we see that Samler is an interesting technique, and it's a nice technique, I like that technique, that it actually tries to actually put clusters of events together and try to take the cluster heads and accordingly build up the summary. Okay. So this is a standard technique we know on summarization which people, but here after some time the number of clusters actually begins to degenerate. So initially Samler works better, but Samler suddenly goes down as the number of tweets goes. Okay. So this is about summarization, and just to post-process or post-mortem, what we see that the classification step where we did that simple thing of not working with tweets but working with tweet fragments, which is a simple hack, actually improves the performance by 50%. So just to tell, when we are taking all those other things, also to be fair, we have worked with tweet fragments and not tweets. Okay. So, but things are not so rosy. As we see this, things are actually not so rosy. The current information coverage is 53%, so that is not very good. So, about whatever the information is there, the current information coverage is around 53%. So which is good because you are doing a summary, okay, but may not be effective. So can we identify, so there are two things. As soon as we see this, there can be two things which can, I will just tell you, we have a disaster management project and we are taking this back to the people who manage disaster, the NGOs, and we show them the tweets and come back and try to have several understanding that what is essentially happening. So there were two things which we noticed or which we understood from them, that actually in disaster there are various types of interest which work. Okay. So there are rescue workers, there are law and order enforcement agency. So rescue workers may not need all the tweets which law and order agencies need. Okay. So the information requirements means, if I am a party of disaster management, my information requirement is not homogeneous. Okay. The information requirements also varies from what type of interest you are actually representing. So one important point which is needed is, can we identify different situational subtopics and summarize them accordingly? So this is task one. Task two is, this is what I have told you again, that when we see situational tweets or when we see tweeters, there are a lot of repetitions. So Twitter inherently has a lot of repetitions. Okay. So there are retweets, but there are actually a lot of near duplicate tweets. Okay, so near duplicate tweets is an important research study in Twitter also. So how to identify near duplicate tweets. So, but near duplicate tweets are not duplicate tweets, so you cannot simply remove them. I will come to them and try to actually leverage on. So first is subtopic identification. So these are, actually we took a, so this is again the contribution of our colleagues from Qatar, QCRI. So they developed a supervised technique, which is called AITR. And we did it for subclasses of earthquake like infrastructure. We have seen this subclasses, which may be interesting, like infrastructure and utilities, injured or dead people, missing trapped or found people, displaced people, shelter and supplies, caution and advice, volunteer or professional service, animal management. So these are the subclasses which people begin to tell us these are the subclasses based upon which you have to develop actually the summaries, which we did. Okay, so with AITR, this was a multi-topic classifier, which we, so it was already done, which we are with them, which we, with their help, we customized a bit, and we got topics varying across different disasters based on the needs of organizations. Okay. I am not going into this. So with this subtopics identified, now we go to abstractive summarization. Okay, with the subtopics identified, now we go to abstractive summarization. So what is the difference between extractive summarization and abstractive summarization? So in extractive summarization, we see like highlights of the day. So it's just taking some part of a movie and showing you highlight of the day. While abstractive summarization would be more fusion of two tweets and making a meaningful tweet. So as you understand, for us, even first of all, Twitter's language is bad. Okay, Twitter's language is bad. Secondly, when we try some machines to actually merge two tweets and make a meaningful tweet, the language has all the possibility of even deteriorating. Okay, so again, abstractive summarization has two, three things. One is you need coherence. Okay, the first word should not come last and the last word should not come first. That is coherence. And you need readability. So if I just take these two things, that if I try to merge, so if I try to make a précis from an article, so I need coherence and I need readability. So in tweets, we actually don't need coherence because we are giving information and each information is actually independent. So that way we are a bit safe, so we can try things. And second is, we really don't, when we talk about readability can be interpreted in many ways. That readability means how good it is in terms of English language. Or we can think that how good in terms of understanding. So it can be a very bad English language which has broken grammar, but we can still understand it. If we can understand it, the person in the control center sitting there, understanding is good enough. Okay. So now, because we are not writing a literature book, we are writing something or effective something which is important for the people. Okay. So with these two things in mind, let us see. So what we see in many of this extractive summarization, so see this, Tharara Tower built in 1832 collapses in Kathmandu during earthquake. Second tweet which was taken up is historic Tharara Tower collapses in Kathmandu after 7.9 earthquake. So what is important here, in the second tweet the 7.9 is there, which is not there in the first tweet. But as soon as you do extractive summarization, because numbers are very important and you don't want to miss numbers, both the tweets come. Okay, so if we can do an extractive summarization where we try to build up Tharara Tower built in 1832 collapses in Kathmandu after 7.9, then it would save a lot of space and you get a much more effective summarization. So with this we generate a word graph. So we generate a word graph with bigrams. So something like this. We begin to march tweets. Like you have Tharara Tower built in 1832 collapses in Kathmandu after 7.9 earthquake. So you can actually travel. So what is happening is we are marching tweets based upon bigrams. Wherever the bigrams match between two tweets, we march those tweets and build up paths. And then we do random work on those paths and generate effective paths which are actually combining two tweets. So what you can understand that there are two tweets. One is with this color, another is with this color. Okay. So now what happens, you can go Tharara Tower collapses in Kathmandu after 7.9 earthquake. Okay. You can combine two tweets by traversing those paths and get much more effective paths. Okay. So there are some constraints on which we build up this. we do this right number. One is favor sentences combining two or three tweets. So if we try to combine six, seven, eight tweets, it doesn't work. It becomes very bad. So this is through sheer practice we understood. It's not good to work more than two, three tweets. We combine tweets which has high intra sentence similarity, but not so high so that it becomes duplicate. So there is a sweet spot which has to be taken where the intra similarity is high but not high enough. Okay. And the second is we try to do something on linguistic quality and again build up an ILP model combining all these factors. So you have schools of sentence generated linguistic quality, intra sentence similarity, and accordingly you can build up an objective function and build up the construct. So all this is good, but again problems come. Okay, we stumble upon this. So remember one of the important criteria which we put up in the beginning, that runtime complexity cannot be high, because if it takes the whole day to summarize and then give it to the control center, it is better not to give it. Okay, it's better not to give it. So one of the important things is when. So what we were seeing, that we were actually generating 80 lakhs parts. So something like this, which from if I try to combine tweets and try to generate the independent paths which are coming, it was actually exploding, which was fine, it was working, quality was coming, but time is not actually optimal. Okay. So the point which we thought is, we have this idea of extractive summarization. So do extractive summarization first. Reduce the tweet set, because extractive summarization, when we were doing extractive summarization of say 50 tweets, okay, and getting 53% coverage. But if we had done extractive summarization of 200 tweets, then immediately the coverage was increasing much higher. Okay, so do the extractive summarization and then do abstractive summarization. So as soon as we do extractive summarization, and which is very fast, things becomes manageable, and then you do abstractive summarization, things becomes real time. So then we have this model, extractive abstractive summarization, and this is the entire scheme. You have tweet string, you have the idea classification, which is bringing out infrastructure, machine, shelter, and then you have the online extractive summarization. With this online extractive summarization, you run another sort of ILP and build up the final summary of extractive summarization. Okay. So again, the baselines. If you see baselines, again, we will see that in some we are performing, like infrastructure, we are performing decent. In missing, we are performing better. In shelter, even better. So to be fair, again, I should tell, in many cases, still abstractive summarization is working good. Because extractive summarization is still working good than abstractive summarization. Because you are doing a lot of processing on those tweets, which brings in noise, and in some cases, which I think this is a case in shelter on day one. Okay, in shelter on day one, we see that our tweet is actually so. Counts is our previous algorithm on extractive summarization. Coils is our now algorithm on abstractive summarization. So if you see this, yeah, on rate-wise, I get this. So if you see this, the extractive summarization is working better, because all this processing actually brings in some sort of noise, where in many of the cases, it's still not working good. So we are actually, I told you this is a work in progress. So this is one thing which is making us think that how to actually make it more effective. Okay, so see this, I guess these are not very bad from the readability point of view. 15 meter relief and 96 NDRF personal relief dispatch NDRF to Nepal. So which is not pure English language, but anyway, I think I understand, and you will tell that you also understand. Okay. So it's understandability wise, it's pretty effective. Okay. All this is good, but then there is another interesting thing which we are observing, that this summarization comes every hour or every, so it's for our case it comes after every 6 hours. So this summarization. So but there are some informations which are continuously changing and which cannot be actually captured in this summarization framework. So then see this, like there are some frequently changing new models, like 7 killed in Hyderabad. So at 2:13, at 2:16, at least 15 feared dead, 2:19, 10 killed, 2:27 killed. So the numbers are continuously changing, and if you have to wait for 6 hours to have a summarization, it's not doable. So then what we need beyond summarization, we need a fast summarization sort of thing, which should actually supplement this. We need a fast summarization which should actually supplement this. So what we do some sort of table lookup scheme to handle this. So there are some important main verbs like killed, the injured, died, stranded. Okay, these are some important main verbs. We build up a table where we have these main verbs and we begin to put numbers continuously. As soon as a number comes on this main verb, we begin to put those things. So there are NLP challenges. You can understand that 15 people killed, 50 injured in Hyderabad class. Whether killed is with 15 or 50 is difficult. These are small things which we as human being immediately understand, but these are small things which are difficult to understand. So we actually explore some sort of dependency relationships and we take numerous, modify the main verb to direct object. So some sort of hack that we do to actually solve this sort of problems. So this is good, and the precision is 0.95, which we are always been able to capture those numerals and get it associated with the verb. So now this is a fascinating graph. Actually, after we do this, we try to plot the numbers. Okay. So after we do this, so x-axis is the number. X-axis is a quit, say timeline, and y-axis is number of people killed. Okay. So in normal stress, what should be the expectation? The expectation would be the number of people killed would slowly rise and then stabilize. The number of people killed, so this is timeline, okay, this is timeline, and this is the number of people killed should slowly rise and then it should stabilize, okay. Killed cannot go down, okay.
So these are tweet numbers.
Yeah, these are tweets which has reported killed, and this is a timeline, okay. These are tweets which have reported killed, and this is the timeline. So what we see that a huge amount of spikes. Okay, huge amount of spikes. So what can be the reason for these spikes? There are two. One obvious reason is there are rumors. So there are rumors going on in the system where people are suddenly telling that 15 people died, 10 people died, okay, 20 people died. So people are actually spreading rumors. One. Number two is which we realize that it is actually not real, may not be rumors, because what is happening, I am a person who is on ground. I see 20 people has died now, but 7 people has died has been reported perhaps just 5 minutes ago. And when the 7 people have died has been reported, somebody important retweeted. And then that retweet begins to pick up. So this 15 people died, when it comes, you see a continuous amount of retweet of 7 people died. So this just stays as a spike, and it is very difficult for people on the control ground to understand whether this 15 people died is a real information or it is a information, it's a spurious information. So then you have to actually characterize the nodes who are actually putting the information. So there is another part of the work which we will not talk, but can we actually identify local experts who will give authentic informations to actually solve this problem. But see, this problem, when we do work, see that we send, put our, make our hands dirty, some of these things which we realize, which is difficult to realize when if we don't do this. So this is what, in short about the situational tweets, what we should see that it is has been beneficial to work with tweet segments that tweets. Distinct lexical and syntactic features are present. Content words play a key role. Abstractive phrase helps in increasing. Special arrangements need to be dealt with actionable keywords. Okay, and detection of filtering and false information is also necessary. So this is the entire spectrum which we see. So situational. So when we started, we thought situational tweets are most important. I actually put a underline on the useful term, if you remember. I put it up, useful, and our mindset was situational tweets are actually most useful. Okay. So then we were seeing the non-situational tweets. So a student has to do PhD, he needs more work. Okay. So then he began to see non-situational tweets. And these are some of the non-situational tweets. I talked about it. It's like big condolences to Nepal earthquake victims, natural disasters are hard to digest. So sentiment opinion. Then you have political opinions. If you are linking Modi, Kejriwal or any other politician for a cheap joke, okay. Charity, I donated, please donate generously. But then we begin to see that there are a lot of communal tweets which are going on. Okay. So you can see so what we can understand that for a event like Hyderabad blast or a Paris bomb attack, there will be a lot of communal tweets. Okay. That is understandable, that since this events has communal overtone, perhaps this can. But what we begin to see that in natural disasters also, there are a lot of communal tweets which are going on. In natural disasters also in man-made disaster we can understand, but we see in Nepal earthquake and Kashmir flood, these are completely natural disasters which has nothing to do with communal things. But after some time, there is a lot of communal tweets which are going on. So then, one of the effective things which we can do is perhaps filter them, or perhaps at least identify them and give some sort of warning. I don't know what to do, but just to identify them may be important. So coming up with our general framework of building event-independent classifier to identify communal tweets, we again built up an event-independent classifier, and there are some of the words which are important, like negative religious phrase, communal hashtags, race terms, communal slang terms. But in general, slang terms are hugely communal. Okay. So then we worked on Nepal earthquake, Kashmir flood, Gurudwara shooting, and with various type of district users, and we get with annotation, inter-annotator agreement, all sorts of standard things which we do, and we get accuracy of around 80%. We get an accuracy of around 80% through which we identify. And again, for the previous cases, we see that we don't degenerate, or we don't the accuracy doesn't go down if we do it on cross domain. Okay. The accuracy doesn't go down. So one thing which we were actually not beginning to understand, why this 20%, and why this 20%, is understanding sarcasm is, we know in natural language processing, sarcasm understanding is difficult, and a lot of tweets are actually sarcastic tweets, and which we were actually missing. Like, you see, terrorists have no religion, but they have faith. This is a very sarcastic tweet, which our classifier actually couldn't handle. So, after that, again, you begin to see how things are going on the ground. So there are some alarming things which we see, that communal tweets are retweeted more than random tweets. So if you see the retweet pattern, communal tweets are retweeted. This is fine, this paragraph is understandable. But communal tweets are retweeted more in natural disasters than man-made disasters where there are communal overtones. So this is interesting, because perhaps people are aware that a lot of communal tweets will go on, agencies are aware, so they are actually stopping them, or somehow people begin to understand socially also, at this juncture I should not post communal tweets, something like this. So you see that in national disasters the communal tweets overtone is much more, and this is also interesting that in man-made disaster the communal tweets spike and then it goes down, but in natural disaster it continuously stays communal tweets to be. So there are various sorts of users. I don't want to go into this. There are various sorts of users, and there are actually some very very popular users who are actually doing this. So that's a bit alarming. Okay. But there are good sites also. So we see that people who are posting communal tweets are also deleting them. Okay, so the deletes can come due to various reasons, and one of the important sociological study of deletes say that deletes comes due to regret, that people regret after sometimes doing this. So we see that the number of communal tweets deleted is much much higher than number of random tweets. So that may be a good sign that people perhaps are thinking more, and there are also people who are posting anti-communal tweets. So some users post. So there are people, not so popular users. So the challenge is how to promote such tweets. Okay, how to actually, even personally I would not go for banning anything, but how to actually balance tweets so that you get all sorts of ideas. So one thing can be done, perhaps we see in Facebook now, as soon as one information is coming, two, three other informations are coming. So it may be that when you get a communal tweet, you also post some anti-communal tweets along with it and you say that these things are. Okay, so this is in short what we are doing. So we have also worked on, there are 10-15% information exclusively available in Hindi. Also, so these are small things which I should say. So when we take the English quiz and Hindi quiz, and we begin to see the position information. So we take the position information of them and try to build up tag clouds and see from where in Hindi quiz are coming and English quiz are coming. The tag cloud is not from the same place. So Hindi quiz are mostly, so this is understandable, but we also get it from Twitter that Hindi tweets are actually coming. And then there is a whole lot of code switching which goes on, and that is also another interesting observation which we see, that in most probably when you are talking in Hindi you are giving opinions, and when you are talking in English you are giving facts. So this is one of the important observations which are okay. So this completes. So thank you, and wish us luck that some of the papers get accepted.
Yeah, please.
What is the corpus of research related to Indian language tweets?
So you have these tweets, out of which 10% are like Hindi. So we have collected all those.
No specific, but you did it only localized.
No, we are actually building up the classifier on Hindi tweets also. So the same thing we did on Hindi tweets, and we are getting the classification and according to it.
Because there is a sense of being natural if you are tweeting in natural language.
In your own. So that's why I'm telling that when you see Hindi tweets, so when we're thinking of this code switching, we see a lot of emotions in the vernacular language, while the English language still stays.
Okay.
There is a question.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Thank you. I have a question. I have some kind of question. I'm sure my example. I'm talking about examples. Really work on some kind of business, a customization. It means
Yeah, yeah, there are some works, there are some recent works on sarcasm detection which is coming out, but sarcasm detection in general is difficult. So there are, now you see a lot of works coming out in the sarcasm sphere. So yeah, we plan to use some of them. So since our main target is not sarcasm detection, but we realize that we plan to use some of the techniques and improve our classification. If some of the papers get rejected.
Yeah, we also use interviews as a method for generation, says Roy. We also collect interviews from the participants in the social media activity.
I knew also?
Interviews. Some people collect data through interviews. You also collect data through interviews or only crawl?
No, it's some crawl. So, but we go back to the people and show them that. So I will tell you one more anecdotal thing, is that when we showed people, showed Policy Rocha, the people, disaster management people, the quiz, one of the important things which they were saying is that, very good, what you have shown is very good and it's good research, but we get many of this information from other sources and Twitter is really not necessary. What is necessary many times is, can you give us micro informations like X is stranded in that village, that doesn't come up in the top. So those sort of micro informations, can you bring out from those? So this is one of the directions which we are working, that how many micro informations, because you get all these micro informations are very important. So it may help a mother. So those sorts of things. So this is one thing you learn when you talk to people, that something which you are doing may not be so much effective ultimately.
Okay, sorry, this is a very interesting talk. In fact, I have 5 questions in my mind, but I'm not going to ask in the interest of time. Let's just stop here. There will be a tea break just after this session, and Eloy will be here, I think, the rest of the day. So please catch him. I'm sure this has sensitized you enough. So thank you, Eloy.